If I don't point down the Chabad and Moshiach, I received a paper from fine Talmud Chacham, Rabbi Yaakov Lieberman, about the Gemara in Sanhedrin and parallel Yerushalmis and Midrashim about Moshiach Min HaChayim, Moshiach Min HaMeisim, in which I will share with you his conclusion. His conclusion is that the belief in Moshiach coming from the Meisim appears to have been a common belief during the times of the Gemara. Multiple sources that discuss the possibility of Moshiach coming from the Meisim from Chazal, Rishonim, and Achronim have been quoted. As Moshiach from a Meisim as it relates to the Rambam La'alacha, Rambam Hilchos Melachim, Perek 11, Halacha 4, codifies how to identify Becheskas Moshiach and then the Vadei Moshiach. Ro'ilios Moshiach, the sage who is fit to be Moshiach, whether alive or a mace, has no halachic status in the Rambam. Similar to the status or term Posek Ador, Sar HaTorah, there are no special halachic status associated with this quasi-status, other than he is a great Torah sage. Rambam Igeres Chias HaMeisim, Perek Vav, states Hashem can resurrect anyone he wants, anytime he wants, during the time of Moshiach, or before or after Moshiach dies. We thus see that the Rambam holds Chias HaMeisim can be anytime Hashem wants, even before the days of Moshiach. Rambam's Igeres Chias HaMeisim during the days of Moshiach, or before or after Moshiach dies. If at the will of Hashem, a tzaddik that is royally Yos Moshiach will be resurrected and then start to perform the signs codified by the Rambam Becheskas Moshiach and then Vadai Moshiach, for sure the Rambam ruled this tzaddik as Becheskas Moshiach and Vadai Moshiach. Such Moshiach Min HaMeisim was not ruled out by the Rambam La'alacha. Maybe the will of Hashem that we see Becheskas Moshiach and Vadai Moshiach speedily in our days coming of Moshiach now. That is all quite true. Possibly, and I have no qualm with learning that way. He goes through the Rashis, which we spoke about a couple of weeks ago, and explains them in very nicely. But again, if you're not a Chassid, this begs a question: why would it be the Rebbe? Why not? He goes to whether David HaMelech would have been Mashiach, not been Mashiach. When we say who David Batzmo, do we mean that, or do we mean something else? Not for now. But why is it not say? Why is it not somebody like the Chasam Sofer or Moshe Feinstein, or going back to Malo B'Kodesh, Rashi or the Rambam or the Ramban? And the answer is that if you're a Chabad, it has to be the Rebbe because he's the closest. But if you're not a Chabad, then this, the fact that Moshiach can be a Meisim means nothing. It just means that Moshiach might be a Meisim, but certainly we would not then say that we can identify or should identify who this personage is. That would only be the case if you actually were a chassid and were determined to identify your rebbe, which it certainly should not be binding on anybody else who does not perceive the rebbe as derichi the klolis, regardless of who it is. Moshiach should come. B'mehera b'yameinu. Amen.